Thank you, Jesus. Wow, let's pray first. Lord, good morning, and wow, it's a good to spend, Lord God, the first day of the week, Lord God, with you. And yes, Lord, we're putting you first. We're here because, Lord, we prioritize you more than anything else. Because our purpose is to love you. It doesn't matter what we do, Lord God. It doesn't matter, Lord God, what our profession is, Lord. As long as we are loving you, we are okay, Lord God, in your sight. And yes, God, andito kami para ipakita sa iyo, Panginoon, na mahal ka namin. So today, we're expectant for your touch, for your move. We want a word from you. We want, Lord God, na mabusog because we are hungry for you. And we're not just hungry. We need you in our lives. Your word is our nourishment. So bless us today. Holy Spirit, move in our midst today. In Jesus' name. Everybody say?
Amen.
So, pinag-uusapan pa rin po natin, okay? Ang topic about purpose-driven. Sino dito blessed na blessed last week?
Yes.
Amen. And so, I'm gonna dig deep, okay, on this topic more. Okay, purpose-driven. God wants that our lives will be purpose-driven. Now, bigyan ko lang po kayo, or let me lay a foundation, okay, what is this all about? Okay? But before that, for how many years po nan ako po ay nagpapastor, isa po sa mga napansin ko or commonly asked questions na mga tao ay ito. Okay? They would ask about, what does God want me to do? Okay? What does God want me to do? Lahat ng tao, okay, o karamihan rather, ay tinatanong, ano ba ang gusto ni Lord na what? Nagawin ko. Okay? May naniligaw sa akin. Ano ba ang gusto ni Lord na gawin ko? Makikipagkaibigan ba ako o babasti din ko na agad? What does God wants me to do? Personally, sino po ito yung tanong niya ngayon, no, sa kanyang buhay? Diba, ano bang school, diba, o work na papasukan ko? What does God want me to do? Where? Saan? Kaya anong gusto niya na maging course ko? Anong gusto niya na maging profession ko? Okay, what does God want me to do? Bibili ba ako ng kotse? O for the next 3 years, yung kotse namin na ito ay gagamitin namin? O gusto ni Lord na bago? Mag-aanak pa ba kami? What does God want us to do? Or, ito na, okay, settle na kami sa tatlong anak. Okay, magpapastor ba ako o magbi-business? 'Di ba? What does God want me to do? Okay? So 'yan po ang tanong ng madami. Actually po ang generation natin ngayon na tinatawag na millennials ay particular kung sino sila magiging. Sa totoo lang, kung sino sila magiging. Okay, particular sila sa magiging business nila, kaya ayaw nila nagba-barbecue, di ba? Bakit? Kasi particular sila, to be honest, because the social media are rising right now, particular sila sa kung anong ipopost nila sa Facebook, sa kung anong sasabihin ng tao sa kanila. Particular sila na dapat may kotse sila, dapat maganda sila, dapat may trabaho sila. O sa mga pastors, particular sila sa church membership nila, dapat madami. Why? Because to impress. Amen. And so sometimes, ang ating decision making na aapektuhan ng gusto nating maging impression ng tao sa atin. And so the question is, what does God wants me to do? Okay? Tinanong natin yung tanong na yan, dapat maintindihan natin, okay, para masagot, hindi ng mundo, pero masagot ni Lord, tignan natin, what does God really care about? If we're gonna ask the question, what does God want me to do? Okay, set aside natin yan. But what does God really care about? And makikita po natin sa Bible, okay, I'm gonna connect that to our topic, purpose-driven. Kasi mas maiintindihan natin, kasi baka last week madami tayong misconceptions, aayusin ko ngayon. Okay, what does God care about? Okay? I'll go straight to the point, wala na tayong oras. Actually po, God doesn't care, okay, on what you do, but God cares about who you are. So this is a foundation that we need to lay, because yung last week, diba, maybe na-meditate nyo on good, you're gonna apply it, but you know, this part is gonna clear things out. Because purpose-driven, when you say purpose-driven, listen to me, purpose is different than vocation. Purpose is more than just what you do. Purpose is who you are. So God cares about, para maintindihan natin, okay, who wants to be a purpose-driven person? Okay, that maintindihan po muna natin, that God is particular on who you are, not on just what you do. God is particular not on your vocation, but on who you are. So first, I want you to write this down. What about purpose-driven ate? Purpose is about who than what. Purpose is about who than what. Say amen if you agree. Hindi po masama mag-amen. Come on. Yeah. 1 Thessalonians 4:3. Sabi niya rito, God's will for you is to be holy. So particular si Lord, hindi sa kung anong gagawin mo, because you know, we're talking about purpose driven. Ang tanong mo, ano ba ang purpose ko? Should I enter this job? Should I quit this job? Should I become a pastor? Should I, you know, enter into what? Into this or that? Now, ano bang will ni Lord? Hindi sinasabi ni Lord na wala siyang pakialam kung saan ka papasok, kung ano magiging vocation mo. But may priority more than that. And God's will is for you to be what? Holy. Okay? Ano ulit ang will sa'yo ni Lord? To be an accountant? Anong will sa'yo ni Lord? To be a pastor? Anong will sa'yo ni Lord? Maging campus missionary? No, God's will for you is the who first than what you will do. So that's what? That's what purpose is all about. Pag tinignan po natin ang Greek word kay nung holy, ng 1 Thessalonians 4:3, Greek word means set apart. Okay? To be what? To be different. Okay? You are not to look like okay, the others. Dapat pag nakita ka, hindi ka katulad ng iba. Okay, so yun ang sinasabi ni Lord, that God wants you to be set apart. It doesn't matter what you do, although yes, God cares about that, siguro secondary, third, but what God cares about is who you are as you do what you do. Amen. Kaya po, hindi niyo po napansin, okay, si Lord, okay, sa Bible, wala siyang pinag-uusapan na vocation. Wala siyang pinag-uusapan na career. But focus siya on what? On 1 Thessalonians 4:3, his will is for someone to be holy. So his focus on character. His focus on what? On who you are. His focus on your calling or your purpose. As a matter of fact, nga, pag pinag-uusapan ang vocation sa Bible, ano po nababasa ninyo? Pag pinag-uusapan ang career, ang vocation, ano usually na nababasa nyo, lalo na sa New Testament, lalo na kapag si Jesus Christ ang nagre-release ng salita, most of the time, pinapag-give up niya. Wala akong kausap. Because who you are following are much more important than what you are doing vocationally. So when we say purpose-driven, huwag kayong mamoblema. Like, ano ba, magbibusiness ba ako? Magpapastor ba ako? Ano ba ako? Mag-a-abroad ba ako? Sandali. Purpose is who? Before do. Sabi mo nga yan sa katabi mo. So instead of asking, what God wants me to do? Though that's a good question when you are under God's will, you can ask those questions. Like for example, ako tinatanong ko yan, what does God want me to do now that I'm doing my purpose? Okay? And wag po natin i-disregard yung tanong na yan. But, you know, para sa atin, itong tanong na ito is, you know, major. When we're using this question Okay, in our major decisions, don't ask what does God want me to do, but ask who does God want me to become, or what does God want me to become? Amen. Kapag nag-umpisa ka sa kung sino, because that's purpose is all about. Pag nag-umpisa ka kung sino, eventually, the do will what? Will come after. Diba? Kapag nag-umpisa ka sa kung sino ka talaga muna, okay, yung dapat mong gawin at yung direksyon sa dapat mong gawin will what? Will what? Will just follow. When you are becoming what God wants you to be, you will hit what God wants you to do. Do you agree with this?
Yes.
Kaya ako, di ba, pwedeng ako, no, ang tanong ko, will ba ni Lord na magpastor ako? O pwede ko ba sabihin sa inyo, hoy, I am under God's will because I am a pastor? No. Okay? Hindi lang ito ang will ni Lord. Ang will sa akin ni Lord is what? Yung character ko maging maayos. Leading a church is what I do. Okay? But my character is who I am. Ang gusto ni Lord is kung sino ako habang nagpapastor ako. Pwede ako nagpapastor, pero I am out of God's will in my life. Amen. Pwede nagpapastor ako, pero yung puso ko hindi tama sa Diyos. For example, di ba, ang galing-galing ko mag-preach sa stage. But pag umuwi na ako sa bahay, okay, yung faithfulness ko kay God pagdating sa aking private life ay hindi effective. Wala ako sa will ni Lord at hindi masaya si God sa buhay ko. Kung ako ay rebelde sa mga magulang ko, abusive ako sa tumutulong sa amin sa bahay, alam mo, sasabihin sa akin, Lord, nak, mas maganda hindi ka nalang magpastor. Kahit business woman ka, pero yung character na gusto ko sa'yo, pinufulfill mo, I'm okay with that. Amen. Because who to God, okay, who you are to God matters than what you do. So I'm actually, inaayos ko yung perspective ninyo about purpose. Di ba? Mas magugustuhan pa ni Lord na hindi ka na, di ba, na hindi ka na full-time sa church eh. Na tama ang puso mo than being a pastor or being a full-time, than not hitting God's purpose for your life. So, pwede ang tanong mo, anong trabaho, sandali, mahalaga yung tanong na yan, pero magandang sagutin natin is this. Okay, sino ka? No matter where you are, what's more important is who you are. So instead of thinking what, think of who. Instead of thinking what, oh, I want to be, diba, someone great in the future, think of, diba, someone what, who is what, great now, someone who is faithful now. So purpose is who, than what. Amen?
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 So, number two. Purpose is about why than what. So, purpose is about why and what. Taas na kamay ulit ng gusto maging purpose-driven siyang tao. Who wants that we will be a purpose-driven church. So, purpose is about not what we do, but it's about why we're doing what we're doing. You know what? Ang mga motibo natin, they matter to the Lord. Okay? Proverbs 16:2, sabi po dito, you may think everything you do is right, but the Lord judges your motives. Okay? You know, sometimes, sa totoo lang, aminin natin, iba ang sinasabi natin sa halaman ng puso natin. Tama po ba? Ay, sa totoo lang, tumutulong ako kasi, you know, I care about you. Pero sa totoo lang, may motibo ka. Nagpapastor ka, mahal mo si Lord, pero alam mo sa puso mo, may motibo ka. I mean, you're serving the Lord, pero, you know, sometimes you think that what you do is right. But, you know, God is more particular about what? Your motives. Ako, ganyan ako sa tatay ko. Amen. Bigla ko na lang siya lalambingin. Hi pa, love you. Gwapo mo ngayon. Iba ka. As in, totoo. Mahal kita. Love you. As in pa, I'm willing to support you. Talaga? Yes pa, grabe. Love you. Pa, o nga pala, kasi ganito. Kasi may ano kami, may plano kasi po ako eh. May opportunity. What do you think pa? Pero may mga pera. Okay. Kaya pala mahal mo ko ah. Kaya pala nilalambing mo ko. You know what? Sometimes alam ni Lord eh. Kung ba't mo siya nilalambing eh. Sometimes alam ni Lord bakit mo ginagawa yung ginagawa mo ngayon. That's why, you know what, we must always pray the prayer of David. You know, when he prayed Psalms 139, Psalms, search my heart, O God. Lord, search me, O God. Know my thoughts. Ako po nakakalungkot minsan, ang motibo ko, horrifying. Na kapag tinest ko na yung heart ko, lalo na when I'm in the presence of God, kapag dalawa na lang kami ni Lord, nakakalungkot ang motibo ko, self-centered. Hindi siya God-centered, hindi siya people-centered. Maybe what I do looks like God-centered, what I do looks like people-centered. Amen. Because again, purpose is not what you do. Purpose is a matter of the heart. Amen. You know what? It's impossible for you to go to the right place when you have the wrong motives. So purpose is about why. Hindi natin pinag-uusapan dito kung magbe-business ka o hindi. Hindi natin pinag-uusapan dito kung mag-nurse ka o hindi. But purpose is about why are you doing what you're doing. Diba? Bakit ka bibili ng kotse? Dahil talagang gusto mo na may transportation ka, nahirap ka na? O dahil gusto mo na may ma-post sa Facebook? Or if you want what to make a statement that yeah that you're capable. Amen. Why are we doing this camp? We really need to ask why? Are we impressing one another here? Are we making a statement that hey, yung church natin may activity o yung church natin kaya to, okay, magaling tayo. Why are we doing this camp? Amen. Why are you starting a business? So purpose is what? Is all about the why. Sabi ko nga sa inyo last week, nagtatanong siya sa akin, te, sa tingin ko, mali yung ginagawa ko eh. Kasi nagsastart ako ng business eh. Sabi ko, hindi mo naiintindihan what purpose is. Because purpose is about the why. Why before what? Colossians 3:17, sabi dito, in everything that you do, sinasabi ni Paul, it doesn't matter what you do. Kung nurse ka, o nanay ka, o tatay ka, o pastor ka, o campus missionary ka, o estudyante ka. Okay, so yung mga nagbi-business dito, wag niyo isipin na nagkakasala ako, dapat purpose-driven ako. Are you here? Kaya sabi niya, in everything that you do or say, then should be done in the name of the Lord Jesus as you give thanks through Him to God. In everything that you do, in other translation, do it in the name of Jesus. Amen? In everything that you do, ano man ang ginagawa mo, ano man yan, hindi kami particular kung ano yung ginagawa mo. Kahit nagbabarbecue ka lang, if you're doing your purpose, kahit nagbabarbecue ka lang, but if you're following Jesus, if you're serving God, if you're becoming like Christ every day, if you're loving God with all your heart, mamaya na sana yan, uppercut sa dulo, amen, then you're fine. Amen. Naku po, ako lang excited. Whatever you, sabi nyo, whatever. Whatever. Di ate, kasi kailangan, alam mo yun, my decisions will affect my future. Sandali, sandali. You will, what? You will choose the right path. Okay? When you know who you are. And you know why. Diba? You exist in this earth. Sino man ang boss mo, ano man daw ang ginagawa mo, do it in the name of Jesus Christ. Ikaw ay housewife. Amen. At iniisip mo, ah, I'm not fulfilling God's purpose for my life. No. Pwede kang housewife, but you're doing your purpose. You're loving God by loving your husband. You're loving God by loving your what? Kids. You're discipling your kids. Wow, you're fulfilling God's purpose for your life. Amen. So it doesn't matter what. Why are you doing what you're doing? Matters to God. Are you excited?
Yes.
And alam mo, daming tao dito, one day, isang araw, magiging missionaryo ako sa abroad. Sabi ni Rosan Dele, maging missionaryo ka muna ngayon kung nasan ka. Maging faithful ka kung nasaan ka. You know, sometimes tayo, no, hindi natin mabigay yung best natin ngayon because we're bombarded with someday I'll be. God wants the who and the why than what. Amen. Instead of asking, Lord, what's that big thing that is in store for me? I want to be someone, you know, like this. I want to be an author. I want to be, you know, to pastor the biggest satellite or kung ano man. No. Instead of asking that, okay, say, Lord, I'm going to serve you faithfully because it's my heart that matters. Amen. Amen. Wow, are you excited about this? Alam niyo po ba kung may nakita kang successful man of God? Siguro nasa isip mo, siguro kaya successful to kasi may mga big decisions siya sa buhay na talagang wow. 'Di ba? Na itama 'yun na pili niya. No. Successful ang tao niyan because may mga private decisions. Yung araw-araw na mamamatay ako dito. I'm gonna choose to be like Christ. I'm gonna choose to be holy. That's why naging siya yung gusto ni Lord maging siya. Amen. Hindi sa big decisions, but sa araw-araw na nagiging desisyon natin. Magagalit ba ako? Amen. Patatawarin ko ba ito? Amen. Palalagpasin ko ba ito? Okay. Diba? Mamahalin ko pa rin ba ito kahit na may kahit pa? Ay, may ganan. Who before what? Why? Before what? Who before do? Why before what? What's more important is who you are than what you do. I mean, you know what? I went abroad 2008. Pumunta po ako. Sorry, 2008. 4 years ago. 4 to 5 years ago. And pumunta po ako sa Japan. Kami ng papa ko, we were invited by a Japanese church. As in literal, after nun, ayoko na bumalik sa Japan. Kasi for 2 weeks, lagare. Parang inibot namin ng Japan, we preached in English. Okay, may translation tour na Japanese. But anyway, you know what, God did great things. But you know, pinaka nag-struck sa akin is my visit with my tita. And that changed my life. Yung bunsong kapatid ng tatay ko, kasi dun siya nakatira. And you know what, yung tita ko, hindi siya katulad ko na madaming accomplishments. You know, nai-invite kung saan-saan. And you know what, doon kami natulog at the time sa kanila, dumalaw kami. Dito naman kayo, please spend time with us kahit 2 to 3 days. Okay po. And you know what, sabi ko, yung tita ko, na-observe ko ang buhay niya, napakasimple ng kanyang buhay. Ang ganda-ganda niya. Ang puti-puti, parang artista, sobra. And so, malalim siya kay Lord. She's making disciples. But you know what? I watch her life. She loves her kids, her husband. And one time sabi ng pinsan ko sa kanya, Ma, in Japanese, Ma, we have a surprise for you. Yes, ano po yun? Ano yun? Anak? Si Papa, nilinis yung kotse mo. Oy, talaga, opo. Masaya ka. Sabi mo sa Papa mo, thank you. Okay, sabihin ko. And you know what? Sabi ko, Proverbs 31 woman. Hindi siya katulad ko na, you know, come on, fire! But I think, mas born again pa siya sa akin. Amen. She loves God. She prays, you know, long hours of prayer. And she's a great husband. how noble, ay, she's a great wife, a noble wife. You know, not a nagger. Or, well, hindi ko pa alam kung nagger ako, sana hindi, okay. Hindi pa ako nag-aasawa, okay. But sabi ko, Lord, when I grow up, I want to be like her. Because tayo ay focused sa mga big things. We want, sabi ni Lord, what matters is who? What matters is why? Are you here? You know what? Anthony's parents, my fiancé's parents, they're not, you know, yung buhay nila hindi glamorous. But they're helping their relatives. They're a good parents to their kids. And araw-araw, alam mo yon, talagang minamahal ang kanilang mga anak. They're tithing, they're serving the Lord. They're not preaching yet. They're a good follower of Christ. You know, who they are has impacted me more than what they do. And sometimes, particular tayo, doon sa ginagawa natin, sabi ni Lord, you know what? What will make an impact is who you are. I wrote in you know, nasa CR kasi ako when God is revealing this to me. And I wrote, after ko lumabas, sabi ko, when you die, you'll be reminded not on what you do eh, but who you are. Diba? What you made people feel. God, what does you want me to do? Sabi na, ha? That's not the right question. Who does God want me to become? And you know what? Fast forward ng aking buhay, kung ako ay mamamatay, kasama ko ang aking asawa na at the time siguro, definitely, kapag alam kong mamamatay na ako, matanda na ako, siguro 65 years old. Huwag na mama, Jesus name, okay, mga 69, 70, 75. Okay, hopefully buhay pa yung mapapangasawa ko noon. Buhay pa si Anthony noon, okay. Ayoko mauna siya kasi paano na lang ako, okay. Wag ganun. And maybe you know what? Or kayo na lang po pag tumanda or Nanay Inday. Andito ba si Nanay Inday? Magkatabi kayo ni Tito. What are you gonna talk about? You know what? Ang pag-usapan ba namin na Anthony, yung naalala mo nung 20 years old ako, nung tinayo kong history makers. Nung 29 ako, nang, you know, we started U-Belt. Ay, naalala mo ba nung na-print natin ang manuals natin? Ay, crap! Amen. Ay, yung ba pag-uusapan natin? Naalala mo yung mga conference na pinagsalita? Pakilabas nga lahat ng mga certificates sa mga pinagsalitaan ko, ng mga simbaan, napakadami, no? Are we gonna talk about what we did? What are we gonna talk about in dead, diba? Bed. Deathbed. Definitely, we're gonna talk about how we loved each other, what we, diba? Paano kami naging faithful for each other for 40 years. Yung mga anak namin, kung papaano rin sila naging follower ni Christ, katulad namin. Are you here? Yes. Yung pagmamahal namin sa isa't isa, kung paano kami naging faithful, na madami naging nag-divorce, pero we stayed together, we continued loving each other, na kahit ano pang nangyari, ano pang pagsubok, ito, di ba, magkasama kami, di ba, are you here? Pag-uusapan definitely, hindi yung public victories eh, but yung mga private victories. Amen. Yung mga pagtagumpayan mo. Okay. Diba? Yung mga bagay na hindi mo na-announce sa Facebook, yung mga bagay, diba, na ginawa sa inyo ni Lord as a family, as an individual. Naalala ko isang author, kinalabit siya ng kanyang anak habang siya gumagawa ng kanyang libro. At sabi ng anak niya, pali, kalaro tayo. And sabi niya, can't you see I'm doing a book? Daddy's doing a book. Sabi ng anak niya, okay pa, sige, ikaw din. Hindi ako habang buhay bata. Alam mo, sinarado niya ang kanyang laptop. Buong araw, naglaro sila ng anak niya. What does matter really? Amen. What does matter to God? Are you here? And Jesus, when He came here on earth, He was, di ba? Ano ba ang binida niya? Yung ginawa niya? Ano ba ang binida niya? Yung status niya? Ano binida ba niya? Professor niya? Sabi niya, does it matter kung ano magiging papel ko? Kung magiging karpentero ko, fine. But I came here. I know who I am. And I know why I came here. I came here to serve. I came here to save. That's it. Kahit hindi na ako ipanganak sa St. Luke's. Kahit hindi na nila ako paglingkuran, I don't care. What matters is that I am doing my purpose in life, and that's what. What is purpose? Purpose is about who? Purpose is about what? Why? Amen. At kahit torture rin siya, kahit saktan siya, he knew who he was, and he knew why he came. Why? Who? We need to be purpose-driven. You know, it doesn't matter, okay, if you do something big or small. Sa maliit na bagay o sa malaking bagay, be faithful. And I tell you, He will entrust you with big things someday, but it's not about something, it's someone. You know, God wants me to be something. I want to have a brat. And then, God wants you to be someone like Him. Amen. What is our calling? What is our calling? What is our purpose? That's why, ito na, kay wala na akong oras. Anong purpose natin? Last week, ni-reveal ko, love God! Our calling is to love. It's not something we do, it's something who we are. Amen? Our calling is to love God. Our calling is to what? Is to love people. Wow, you love God with your all. You love people no matter what. Kahit ikaw ay businessman, kahit ikaw ay nurse, love God. Whatever you do, hit your purpose. Love God with your all. Focus on that. Are you loving God? Amen. Are you loving people? Alam mo, kapag pinufulfill mo itong ultimate purpose ng Panginoon sa atin, okay, wala na, hindi na tayo mag-worry sa ating future. Kapag lagi tayong, you know, kapag tayo ay nagiging kamukha ni Kristo, are you here? We won't worry about our future because alam natin that we are directed in the right path. Why? Because we are becoming like Christ. Amen. If you're becoming the right who, God will help you choose the right do. If you're driven to the right why, God will lead you to the right what. Matthew 22:37, Jesus replied, love the Lord your God with all your heart. This is our purpose. This is who, this is why. With all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength. This is not being a pastor. This is not being an author. This is not being, you know, sikat. This is not being someone, something. This is life. This is man's all. When we love God, you're a housewife. Love God. Matthew 22:39, and the second is like it. Love your neighbor as you love yourself. You know, may mga taong hindi mo nakikita sa stage, but they're feeding the poor. They're feeding, okay, those who are in need. They're feeding the fatherless. They love people. Our purpose is not to become a pastor. Kung pastor ako at hindi ko to ginagawa, wag na lang. Hanap ako ng ibang profession na mafulfill ko ito. Matthew 28:19, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Are we, okay, snatching souls away from hell? Is our life, you know, being used by God to bring people to Jesus, to bring people to heaven? Is our life Amen. A converting people, baptizing people to be part of God's family. That's our purpose. It doesn't matter what you do. It doesn't matter what your vocation is. Are you fulfilling this? Why are you a nurse right now? There is a purpose. And purpose is who? Purpose is why. Are you excited? Yes. Taas sa kamay nang naintindihan nito. Thank you, Jesus. I want you to close your eyes right now. Thank you, Jesus. And you know what? I just want to get things right. God wants to get things right in our lives right now. Some of you, ang listahan ng purpose nyo is do. Ang listahan ng purpose nyo is what? But God wants you to be someone who looks like Him. God wants you to be someone who is loving, someone who is generous, someone who is faithful, someone who is patient, someone who is not, you know, self-seeking. Because when you die, people will remember who you are and what you do. Yan ang ina-accomplish ng mundo. At yan ang ina-accomplish natin. Title. But purpose is not about title. Purpose is not about accomplishments. Purpose is not about our position. It is not about power. It's not about, you know, success. It's not about promotion. That's not a purpose. Purpose is who we are while we're doing what we are doing. Wow, thank you, Jesus. And we want to love God with our all. We want to love people despite of, in spite of. We want to make disciples. We want our lives to make an impact. God wants us to be purpose-driven. Thank you, Lord. Definitely. Gusto ko maging mayaman. Bakit? Gusto ko magka-business. Bakit? Gusto ko maging nurse. Bakit? Lord, because I want to love you. I want to love more people. Lord, I want to make more disciples. You know, sa dulo ng buhay mo, this is what matters most. Were you a loving father? A loving wife, a loving, you know, sister, a loving, you know, friend. Did you love? You know, our calling is to love. Our calling is to serve. Our calling is to reach out. Our purpose is to make a difference in someone's life. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. I want you to tell the Lord right now, God, help me become like you. Help me become like you, Lord. Help me, God, to shift my focus from wanting to be something to, Lord God, to becoming someone, Lord God, like you, Lord. Your will is for me to be holy. Your will for me is to become like you, Lord. Your will for me is to love God with all my heart. That's what matters most. Search my heart, God. Know my motives, Lord. Reveal it to me, God. Rebuke me. I am willing, God. Change my life. Change my heart. Change my character. Change me, God. Of people, but I want to impress you more than anything else, because you are my audience, Lord. You are my judge. People on Facebook, people around me won't judge me. Hindi sila magja-judge. Ikaw magja-judge sa akin, Lord. And you want me to be a lover. You want me to be a lover. You want me to love. You don't want me to live in hate. You don't want me to live in selfishness. You don't want me, Lord God, to live, Lord God, in pride. You don't want me, Lord God, na mang-apak ng tao. tao. You don't want me to be greedy, God. You want me to give. You want me to serve, Lord God. You want, Lord God, my life, Lord God, to be a vessel where people can be saved, can be inspired, Lord, can be motivated, Lord. I want to help people. I want to reach out. It doesn't matter what I do. What matters is this. I'm a lover. I love you. I love people. I am making disciples. Alam mo, mahirap magmahal kung wala si Jesus Christ sa puso mo. At kung may mga ilan sa inyo, if you want to receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, do it now. You'll be able to love if Christ is in you. Rabahanda rabashikaraba. Come on, talk to the Lord right now. Shikarabahata rabashikaraba. Oh, rababashi,
and everything revolves around you, Jesus, you. There's nothing else that matters, and nothing in this world will do.
Purpose mo, mahalin si Lord. Purpose mo, mahalin ang magulang mo. Purpose mo, mahalin ang mga anak mo, ang asawa mo. Purpose mo is to build memories with them. To love them, to be faithful to them. And those people around you, your purpose is to make an impact in their lives, helping them, seeing how Jesus sees them. You saw something na wala sila na merong ka-share, give. Put your shoes to their shoes and feel what they're feeling. Bring them to Christ. That's it. That's your purpose. Our purpose is not do. What's a do? To be a speaker, that's not our purpose. To be a pastor, to be a businessman, to be a tycoon, to be someone, you know, a popular. I want to be an author. That is not a purpose. But our purpose is to be loving, to be faithful to God, to be generous, selfless, kind. It's a purpose. It's who, it's why, then do and what. Hindi pinapag-give up ni Lord ang profession mo, pero pinapag-give up ni Lord yung maling motibo. Bakit mo ginagawa yan? Sa tingin mo, gusto ni Lord talaga naalisan ang trabaho o kunan ng pera yung rich kid? Rich young man, no. Alam ni Lord na particular yung lalaki sa kung ano kesa sa kung sino siya. And God wants you to shift your focus. He wants you to be like Christ. Ha, grabe. Like Christ. Si Jesus ay karpentero lang, but He made an impact. He loved God more than anything else. He loved people. He loved people. He made disciples. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we we want to be like that, Lord. I want you to talk to Him right now, 30 to 1 minute. I want you to tell God, express to the Lord, Lord, change my heart. Lord, I want to be someone like you, Lord. I want to be like you. Starting today, Lord, I am deciding to focus on my character, Lord. To focus on who I am. Come on, talk to Him.
Around you, in Jesus.
Come on, talk to Him.
And from my heart to the heavens, Jesus be the center. It's all about you. Yes, it's all about you. From my heart to the heavens, Jesus be the center. It's all about you. Yes, it's all about you. And from my heart to the heavens, Jesus be the center. It's all about you. Yes, it's all about you. From my heart to the heavens, Jesus be the center. It's all about you. Yes, it's all about you.
Kapag purpose-driven ka, may pera ka o wala, masaya ka. Kapag purpose-driven ka, kahit nasa stage ka o hindi, faithful ka. Kapag purpose-driven ka, maniwala ka sa akin, kahit na wala kang likes, kahit wala kang followers, kahit hindi ka palakpakan, kahit hindi ka i-appreciate, passionate ka. At kahit na, you know, criticism doesn't matter to you. Because, you know, the applause of people doesn't matter to you as well. Because you're living in one audience. On one audience, and that is God. Our real heroes are someone na hindi mo nakikita sa stage, but they're loving God with their all. Wala nang pera nagbibigay pa sa mga nangangailangan, pambihira. Naglilingkod sa Panginoon kahit na wala na sila. There are real heroes. There are people who are purpose driven. Now, if you think that, you know, ikaw ay grabe, namamayag pag ngayon, don't feel bad, definitely. But why? But madami kang pera. Bakit? But nag-open ang door sa'yo to start more business. But ka napopromote? Bakit? Kaya pareho lang eh. Napopromote ka o hindi, nasa tuktok ka o hindi, pareho lang. Yan ang mga purpose-driven na tao. Rabahata, rabashika, rabah. Yan ang purpose-driven church. Rabahanda rabashi, we want to be someone like you, Holy Spirit. Raya rabahata rabashi, karabahanda rabashi, karabahanda. Oh, basahin mo kami, Panginoon. Pura babashi, karabah, humble us, God, make us loving. Shika, yaya. At the greatest test to love is when you're hurt. Shia, yaya, raya, yaya, bababa. Thank you, Lord. It's all about you.
Oh, yes,
it's all about you.
From my heart to the heavens, Jesus be the center. It's all about you. Yes, it's all about you. From my heart to the heavens, Jesus be the center. It's all about you. From my heart to the heavens, Jesus be the center. It's all about you. Yes, it's all about you. From my heart to the heavens, Jesus be the center. It's all about you. Yes, it's all about you.
Be faithful to God. Do not compromise. Choose Him always. choose Him. Be a blessing to Him. Bless God. Bless God. We always want that God will bless us. You bless God with your life. Bless Him with your life. Be holy. Be sanctified. Be pure. Choose what is right. Choose love. Choose love. Choose love. Rababashikaya rahanda rabashikaraba. Choose love. 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 And you'll be able to love when Christ dwells in you. To those who want to receive Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior, first time mo ngayon, gusto mong mangyari ito, you want to be someone like this, but you're full of anger in your heart, you're full of pride, you're full of darkness, you know that? You want this, you know, to be taken away from you. You want revival in your life. You want change in your life. You want to have a change. You want to you want to be rejuvenated. You want to be transformed. Gusto mo to. You know, isa lang ang key, si Jesus Christ. Kapag pumasok si Jesus Christ sa buhay mo, yan ang umpisa ng lahat, hindi religion. Hindi natin pinag-usapan ng religion. Hindi natin pinag-usapan kung narinig mo na si Christ. Pinag-usapan dito, may relationship ka ba kay Christ? At mag-uumpisa yan kapag tinanggap mo si Jesus Christ sa buhay mo. Secure yourself with Jesus Christ. Life without Christ is hell. You'll bring hell to people because of your attitude, because of your character. And not just that, you'll experience hell. Not just in this earth, but in the age to come. With Christ, kahit may problema, heaven. Accept Jesus Christ. Kung katabi mo new friend, tulungan mo siya, okay? I want you to put your hand sa kanyang shoulder. If you want to receive Jesus, first time mo, new friend ka, o dalawang beses ka na umaatin dito, third time, hindi mo matanggap si Jesus Christ, pero ngayon nagdedesisyon ka, I want you to raise your hands right now. Come on, walang nakatingin sa'yo, ako lang. Raise your hand if you want to receive Jesus. Don't be shy. Raise your hand. That's good. Nakita ako ng dalawang kamay ngayon. Come on. Who else? Thank you, Jesus. Isa pang kamay. Isa pang kamay. Thank you, God. Isa pang kamay. Thank you, God. I want you to repeat after me this prayer. This prayer is not my prayer. Make this your prayer. Receive Jesus and everything will be changed. You'll be a purpose-driven person. Purpose-driven person. I want you to say this prayer with all your heart. Nako, papasok si Jesus sa buhay mo. At hindi ka na magiging katulad ng dati. Sabihin mo, Jesus. Sabihin mo, Jesus. Tinatanggap kita. Bilang aking Panginoon. At tagapagligtas. Pumasok ka sa buhay ko dahil kailangan kita. Tinatanggap ko ang bagong buhay, bagong pagkatao, bagong puso, at ang buhay na walang hanggan na regalo mo. Simula ngayon, susundan kita. Simula ngayon, paglilingkuran kita, magiging disipulo mo ako. I want to be like you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Father, I want to pray for you. Ako na lang magpipray. Raise your hands. Lord, salamat po sa mga bagong kaibigan namin ngayon that they understand, Lord, what life is all about. Life is about you. Life is about loving you, loving people. Thank you, God. For you have transformed their lives. I pray for the Holy Spirit right now to come upon them and dwell in their hearts, making them, Lord God, someone that will love you with all their heart, someone that will love people, will be a blessing around them, and someone, Lord God, who follows you with their all, and soon will make people join them as they follow you. Salamat po sa pangalan ni Jesus. Lahat magsabi ng Amen.